Hi! I'm Anya, also known as Mepity, and today I'll be telling you why every artist should have a website, as well as showing you how you can make your own. Along the way, I'll also be giving general tips about making websites and how to make your portfolio presentable. Also, I have these little aliens on my face. They were meant to be twins, but they're more like distant cousins, so don't mind that. A huge thanks to today's sponsor, Wix. Without them, I wouldn't have my current website, which I made myself and I'm very proud of. I actually started making my own Wix site before they contacted me for this sponsorship, and this just goes to show how much I genuinely love the site and everything it has to offer. That being said, I started out using the ADI, which is the quickest, most simple way to make a website, but for the purposes of this video, we'll be transferring straight into the editor, which allows for much more fine-tuning. Having a website looks professional. It shows you care about your work and how you want to present it. It suggests you're putting that bit more effort rather than relying on some entirely pre-made site. With the Wix editor, you can start with templates made by people who really know what they're doing. There's over 700 to choose from, so I'm sure you'll find something perfectly suited to your needs. This also saves having to do everything from scratch. Someone less tech-savvy, such as myself, won't need to fuss over technical details, but it also doesn't alienate those who are well-versed in web design. Wix is the ideal place for beginners and pros alike. You can also connect your site to a personal domain, as well as have a business email. This makes you look extra professionnel. Whether you choose to use your own email or a business one made through Wix, be sure to keep it simple, sensible, and recognizable to you. No random numbers or words you wouldn't want your grandmother to read. Something essential in this day and age is optimizing your site for mobile. Wix does a great job of transferring your site into a pocket-sized vertical format, which you can view and edit by clicking here. Things aren't always perfect though, so you can adjust stuff to your liking without affecting the desktop version. On to my next point. With a website, you can personalize to your heart's content, creating a unique and personal experience for you, potential clients, and recruiters. Fine-tune as much as you want. It's easier to deviate from cookie-cutter sites with the tools Wix provides. It's also super intuitive because all you need to do is click and drag. The menu makes it easy for visitors to navigate through the pages on your site. Double-click to change the name of existing pages and press Add Page to create a new one. Click and drag the tabs to rearrange the order and make submenus. I used the submenus to categorize my portfolio into different sections. Because I don't have a specialty with my art yet, I separated my work out. This means viewers won't be overwhelmed by large volumes of stuff. Keep your pages organized. Categorize everything and be sure the labels and buttons make sense to the user. You don't want them getting lost and confused. Each page can be arranged in strips. You can snap practically anything into these, and if you want to shift the order, all you do, once again, is click and drag. All the stuff snapped inside will follow, so no need to worry about that. Additionally, you can adjust strip sizes by dragging these little buttons around. Don't go too crazy with fonts and colors. Websites look their best when you have no more than 3 fonts and a consistent color palette that is nice on the eyes. We don't need a rainbow laser fest to fry viewers' eyeballs. Well, unless that's what you're going for. Luckily, Wix makes it easy to keep track of custom themes. You can pick from a wide range of colors and fonts, which then get saved and can be reused across your site to keep things looking uniform. From menus to buttons to galleries, you can pick from a range of styles. From there, you can change things up to look exactly how you want. One of my favorite features is adding animation. With almost every clickable thing, you're given this little speedy diamond-looking icon. Here, you can choose from a bunch of transitions to give each page a little more ho-ho-ho. Again, be sure to keep your use of animation tasteful and consistent, otherwise things might start to look like a 2007 PowerPoint presentation. If you want to get really nitty-gritty, Wix has the Dev Mode. This gives you access to the platform CoreVid, where one of the features is adding your own coding. This type of thing tends to go way over my head, but if you're like me, Wix does have a forum where you can copy and paste code. I used this to make some assets visible only on the mobile version of my site.
If you are a well-versed web developer, you'll know how to use these tools.
I forgot to film this header, but another great feature about websites is that you can present your art in the way that best shows it off.
Okay, so let's back up a little. Wix makes it easy to keep track of all your assets. Here in the media gallery, you can upload images, videos, GIFs, and all other kinds of files. Either upload by clicking and dragging onto the window, or do it from your computer, Instagram, Google Drive, etc. If you don't have something pre-made though, chances are you'll find some pretty great stuff in the Wix gallery. Click over to the Media tab and type in what you're looking for. Wix offers a free selection of images, videos, vector art, and so on. I went pretty ham with making my own assets to give my site that scrapbook feel. When you're going through your site files, you can adjust your images like with regular photo editing. The more pages and decorations you have, the more messy your site files window can get. Luckily, you can add folders to tidy things up, or do what I did and create boards. Right-click on any document and relocate it to the board or folder that suits you. You can then go to the My Board section to see all of your categorized stuff. I've kept all my artwork sorted into different sections of portfolio. This made setting up my galleries a breeze. Whether you draw big, sweeping landscapes, do portraits, or have collections of cute little GIFs, you're no longer bound by square formats or weirdly cropped thumbnails. Instead, you can pick a gallery style to suit your needs. Head over to this plus button and select Gallery. I went with this masonry one because it looks neat but still preserves the aspect ratio of my images. When managing media, you can rename your files, add a description, add links, and shift the focal point of your image for if your thumbnail will be cropped. You can also play with the order of your pictures. In the settings, you can tweak your layout of the gallery, how it's animated, how it loads, and so on. As tempting as it may be, don't always have your images at maximum quality, otherwise your pictures may take ages to load. In the gallery settings, you can adjust how beefy your images are. I tend to keep mine between 80 and 90%. Do this, and those of us not blessed with godly internet speeds will thank you.
A website is a one-stop shop for everything about you. No more do you have to send multiple Google Drive folders and links all over the place. Everything can be housed nice and neatly in one space.
When you press this add button, you can see just how many different things you can put on your site. Something I find especially useful is buttons. These buttons can take users anywhere, ranging from other pages on your site, to elsewhere on the internet, to downloading a PDF of your resume. On my About Me page, I added links to my other social platforms and resume, meaning clients or recruiters can quickly find what they want about me. You can make almost anything a clickable link, but the cool thing with buttons is you can give them hover and clicked modes. Animating them that way makes it feel a little more interactive. Always put your resume somewhere on your site. It helps recruiters and clients know more about you and your capabilities to help them decide if you'd be the right fit. Speaking of About Me pages, this is a unique way to introduce yourself. It can be a short summary with a photo, or can be a full artist statement. This is much more personal than social media bios with character limits.
Having your own website also makes it much easier to connect with clients and followers.
Once again, heading back to the add button, two more important features are contact forms and social bars. The contact form could be set up however you like. I use mine so people don't need to leave the site in order to get in touch with me. It can be for general inquiries, contests, ordering commissions, and much more. The other great way to get people to connect with you is the social bars. You can pick what social media you want to share, as well as the icon style. These are quickly recognizable for visitors and can be placed wherever you like. I tend to place this kind of thing near or in the footer. Always include contact information. Make sure it's super easy to find, like in all the headers and footers, in your resume, in your portfolio, and so on. You want recruiters to do as little work as possible, so you up your chances of scoring a gig. Whenever recruiters have come to my class, they've always warned us about how they've seen so many amazing artists who don't provide contact information, therefore meaning these people lose out on some great opportunities. A side note to this, these days it's not necessary to add a phone number, otherwise you may end up with a bunch of strangers calling you 24/7, but spread the email everywhere. Another way to connect is through setting up groups, forums, and a blog, so your community can engage with you and each other.
I'm talking about websites as if they're only suitable for portfolios, but they can be so much more than that.
Don't forget, your website can be anything you want it to be. Heading back to those 700 plus templates, you can see just how far beyond art you can go. One of the coolest features that I'd like to use is the online store. This is the perfect place to sell merch, prints, online tutorials, or whatever else you'd like. I don't currently actually sell anything, so to show you an example, here's a rock I found. I turned this little beauty into an original piece of art. After taking some glamour shots and adding an online store, head into Manage Store and delete the sample stuff, then list your own products. Here you can add the price, product information, shipping and return info, and so on. You can also organize stuff to operate with filters or to come up with various search terms. Anyway, here is skincare in all its glory. If you want the thing, you can get it for a cool $999.97. It comes with a certificate of authenticity made by yours truly, and 90% of the proceeds will be donated to charity. You can set up your website to accept commission orders. Perhaps set up a link tree so clients pick exactly what they want without causing you a hassle. Do you own a restaurant? You can make a restaurant website. Or if you want to host like a monthly contest for certain artists, you can do that. What I'm trying to say is literally anything can be a website. If you can think it, you can make it with a little help from Wix. After your desired amount of tinkering, your website is ready to go. When that time comes, hit publish in the top right corner so the world can feast its eyes on your work.
This was a whistle-stop tour of Wix and the art of website building. Hopefully now I've given you a couple tools to get yourself started. Don't forget, there's plenty of in-depth tutorials online, so if you need to know something really specific, someone probably already has the answer for you. Don't wait, go out there and make your own website. Down below in the description and the pinned comment is my link, which is wix.com/go/methodtea. Even if you feel like your art isn't good enough yet, or you don't really know how you want to present yourself, starting now is a really good idea. Getting things off the ground means you won't have to panic in the future when, say, your dream studio is coming wanting to look at your work. Thank you so much again, Wix. It means a lot that you reached out to me. I love your stuff. And I hope you guys like it too. Check out the stuff in the description and the pinned comment. You won't regret it. That's all for now. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're all safe and well because it's still Corona times. I'm still stuck in California. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe. I make art videos sometimes. And don't forget to also follow me on Instagram at MepaTea and Mepa2. MepaTea is for more finished work, and then Mepa2 is for random sketches, doodles, I don't know, just whatever else I want. Yeah. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye!